Let's discuss definite integration. Till now we have studied about indefinite integration where we have seen that the result varies by a constant. So what is definite integration? Let's first write it. In this category of integration, we integrate. Integrate means, we have studied that integration means summing up. We integrate the integrand within a specified limits and result will be an absolute value. You can also write unlike to the case of indefinite integration where result varies by a constant, which we already studied that in case of indefinite integration, we cannot evaluate the value of constant of integration. But on the contrary, in case of definite integration, we integrate the integrand within specified limits. We'll just see what these limits are. And the important thing to understand is, in this case, the result will be an absolute value. It is not dependent on any constant. It is always an absolute value. You can also write this, in definite integration, we always specify lower and upper limits of integration. There is a specific procedure how we apply limits and how we substitute the value of limits in the integrand. Let's also discuss the procedure of limits application. If we talk about the procedure of limits application, we can see if we are given with an integrand I is integration of f prime x dx and we apply limits from a to b. Here this b is the upper limit and a is the lower limit. In this case, we know if our integrand is f prime x, its integration will be fx. So, your result will be certainly fx. Now, we put these limits outside the bracket and we substitute upper limit, then lower limit and we subtract the two results of this function. Limits are applied in this manner. We first find f of b minus we find f of a. So, this f of b minus f of a, this we define as result of definite integration. Of f prime x from a to b, where a to b are the limits. So be careful about such type of cases. We'll see some examples to understand the application of limit substitution. If we take up an example on definite integration, say we are required to evaluate I is equals to integration of x squared dx within limits from 2 to 3. Always be careful that the limits we are substituting or we are applying, it must be of the variable with respect to which we are carrying out the integration. Here we know the integration of x square can be directly written as x cube by 3. Now we apply the limits from 2 to 3. If you substitute first the upper limit, you will see the result will be 3 cube by 3 minus then we substitute the lower limit. It will be 2 cube by 3. So here we are getting the result. This is 27 by 3, that is 9 minus 8 by 3. So your result will be 19 by 3. This is an absolute value. This 19 by 3 is the result of this definite integration. If we take up another example, like we need to evaluate I is equals to integration of cos x dx from 0 to pi by 2. We know well that integration of cos x can be written as sin x. So here I can be written as sin x. We don't put any constant of integration, rather than just taking a constant, we apply limits from 0 to pi by 2. Now first we put the upper limit, then we put the lower limit, and we subtract this value. So this will become sin of pi by 2 minus sin of 0. So here we know sin pi by 2 is 1, sin 0 is 0. So our answer to this definite integration is 1. So I think if indefinite integration is clear to you in physics, we don't need the knowledge of definite integration more than this. You must know how to put the limits in the result, rather than using an integration constant.